Dr. Tedeno, just some insight, of course, after the onslaught by Typhoon Karina, in terms of preparedness and action, what have you observed this time around?
There are two issues now we have to note. Number one, the institutional. Although we have really developed our flood mitigation system now through our Metropolitan Manila Development Authority, personally, I can see how we expanded the programs, how MMD expanded the program. But the problem with our waterways, particularly our big rivers, it's not only here in the metropolis. You have to note that it comes from the islands, dito sa Sierra Madre. With lots of incursion happening there, that's where the problem is. Number two is the individual look at how we prepare ourselves now, vis-a-vis or face-to-face with nature. For past 2 years, Philippines is number one in the World Risk Index. And 80% of the hazards that's coming in is hydrometeorological hazard, ESP in Baguio. Now, we have problem individually. Much of the citizenry is not really cooperating. We are blocking our estero. No? Maraming mga informal settlers andoon. Kumakita mo lang yung mga nahakot na mga debris. These are mga items na galing sa isang ng kabihasnan. So we are not really changing our attitude when it comes to preparing. Other than despite the fact na we are being warned bago darating ang bagyo, we have to clean the sewers, the canals and what. And we have to prepare every family with designated evacuation area, although it's not yet ideal. Why? Because emergency shelters must be a dedicated emergency shelter. What we did, we convert our schoolhouses into emergency shelters, which are not really ideal. So that's one thing also. And quite a number of our schools are in the red, in the hazard map, red po, ibig sabihin, bahain, no? At landslide area kung nandun tayo sa the likes of itong mga nasa Panawi area, yung paakyat tayo, kulang-kulang po, pati ang ipag-pastan. Now, if we are too serious with creating a very resilient culture, we have to come up with a dedicated emergency shelters kasi we have no more choice. Philippines has the fifth longest shoreline on earth. You have to know that. Now, we all have all these insults coming in, particularly sa eastern seaboard natin facing the Pacific Ocean. If we will have like 21 to 23 typhoons and around 11 to 13 will make landfall, then we will have problem. Not only because of the flood pressure, but because of the economic issue there. Isipin mo, yearly, instead na mag-progress tayo, babangon lang tayo dahil sa isang pagkaplakta sa pagbaba.
Yes.
Now, we don't have any choice. We really have to do other than structural reconfiguration, yung behavior ng Pilipino. Yesterday, I was discussing with a friend from Amsterdam. Suddenly, you know, your problem is, I know it's not really easy, but you have to copy us. Kasi kami, we are 6 feet below the sea, but
yes,
we don't have quite a problem. No? So yun ang nakita ko, titingnan natin, because after the SONA of President Marcos, I even mentioned about the flood control system. It should be a two-way system. The citizenry must also be involved. No? Yung mga comprehensive land use program, striktuhan natin. Yung hindi pwedeng tirhan, huwag natin tirhan. Yung mga fish pens dyan sa Laguna, di ba? Ayusin natin kasi it creates some sort of a blocking items no, doon sa ano. Kasi nagpag-create ng silt. Kaya yung mga flood waste natin, napaparahan, nag-overflow side to side. Now, our flood is a smorgasbord of flood. Naghalo na po ang riverine flood, ang coastal flood, ang flash flood, nako groundwater flooding, at saka urban flooding. Our way of looking at development is putting cements left and right. Kaya ano na yung absorbing power ng kalikasan? Now, we have to look at it quite in-depth mix. No? Hindi lang ibig sabihin na we create structures to really divert the water. I think our side here right now is using natin as a nation which is being challenged by 86% of hydrometeorological hazard.
Yes, Dr. Ted, no, I'll take a step back and also what the report mentioned earlier about President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos mentioned about climate change and the trash behavior by the people. And you also mentioned it briefly. Do you think, muna, no, just taking it step by step, Dr. Ted, if you think the behavior was kind of changed or was kind of altered ever since Ondoy, like by the people, especially in the low-lying areas, do you think that would have made a difference? Kasi Dr. Ted, Tonday was 2009. And we know that this is a cause also, yung pagbara ng mga estero. And yet, 15 years later, we're still in the same problem, still in the same behavior. Dr. Ted?
Yeah, because we have a short-range memory. Like Indonesia niya yung nangyari sa, although it's related sa earthquake, yung sa Aceh, nagbalikan ulit to. Same thing sa atin. No? Short range tayo, wala tayo yung sabihin natin yung collective sense of being resilient. No? Yung ating priority is just to put food 3 times a day on the table. Wala tayong sense of sacrifice na kailangan is magsasama ako sa religion. Kailangan yung tapunan ng mga ganitong basura doon, lalakarin. So, our trust culture na konting kibot, tapon ka agad, we are not into recycling unlike the Japanese. Now, this is quite in-depth at mahirap pag-uwin. But if we have to do it like sabihin natin, one stone, three birds, number one, yung school natin, baguhin natin yung yung pag-implement ng mga projects sa kabataan na more environment-friendly and understanding hazards that hits our country. Start with that. Number two, yung mga corporate entities, including the church. The church, no? Istriktuhan natin, no? Na kailangan yung ating clean and green campaign taasan natin. And thirdly, yung institutional coverage, lakasan natin. Yung parang kung pwede police power. Look, Mix, if you are in a Pacific country, your house is seen by the government as having no storm shelter, aba Mix, you will be penalized. If you are seen in the middle of the storm, no, tatawid-tawid ka sa baha, you'll go to jail. Dito sa atin, wala eh. Naku, tumawid sa baha, nasa lake, pakaway-kaway pa. Nothing happens. Now, I think these 3 things, no, kung tapangan lang natin, it can be done naman eh. Because great changes of any civilization starts with a very dedicated person, whoever that person is. Parang gawin natin Mandela, Margaret Thatcher, Gandhi, yung magang one man na we have to, ito ang gawin dapat.
Yes. Dr. Ted, now. Yes, go ahead.
You go to Clark. Bakit ang tinok mo magmaneho sa Clark? Aper?
In Subic.
Kasi hindi ka bibiruin. Sa Subic, hindi ka bibiruin. Now, if we have to implement yung tinatawag natin, very conscious tayo sa environment natin because this is what's happening right now, no? Because of our neglect and very low communion with nature, ito tayo ngayon. Ayusin natin yung ating disposal system para hindi mabarhan yung ating mga sewers, no? Kahapon pa lang, may sinita ako. Bakit? Nilinis nila yung kanilang paligid. Lahat ng burak. Saan nila tinapon yung burak? Hinulog din sa Imbornal. The next episode of raining, yung burner will be clogged kasi pwedeng mag-solidify yung mga silt na hinulog nila. Tingnan mo yung ating style. Short range na lang, wala tayong long range na paningin on mitigation.
So infrastructure is really key, as you mentioned.
Yeah, that's why, sabi ko sa iyo, isabay natin yung tatlo. Grabe yung information campaign starting from schools, tapos all hands natin, yung pangalawa, yung kasama yung private entities, parang sabihin natin, passporting. Oh, dito sa ano ha, pag nahuli kayo na hindi nagtapon ng garbage, biro lang ng salary deduction. Parang ganun baga. I-police power na natin, institutional, para yes, ang Pilipino, tumino din na magkaroon tayo ng discipline.
Dr. Ted, now this question is for the benefit of our residents residing in areas like QC, Quezon City, or Malabon even, or some parts of the metro that have experienced this for the first time. Dr. Ted, I'm sure you've had conversations where they say, noon do, hindi naman ganito eh. O nung Ulysses, hindi naman kami pinasok ng ganito eh. But pero ngayon, abot bewang yung baha sa bahay namin. Climate change is a big factor when it comes to that. Also, the type of typhoon of what Karina brought, as Pag-asa mentioned, 461.4 millimeters of rain po, no, this time around. Ba't po ganun, Dr. Ted? Dr. Ted? We have back with us disaster response expert and rescue doctor, Ted Esguerra. Dr. Ted, you're there?
Yeah. As to the question you mentioned a while ago, Migs, now.
Yes. Okay, go ahead.
The scientific communities are looking at vulnerable nations like us. We have already the likes of Kiribati, you know, in the Pacific, where Indian citizens were being relocated to another nation because they're already flooded because of the rising waters. Now Solomon Islands, Vanuatu, Tonga, including us. Now that's gonna be one big issue, particularly with food security. So there will be succeeding hazards that's gonna follow after the global warming. No? So that's what I was telling you. Philippines has the fifth longest shoreline, and out of the 40,000 plus barangay, ang laki ng porsyento ay located along the shoreline. Now, this is the thing that we are looking right now. In fact, we have the Climate Change Commission looking into it, and other academic or sabi natin mga university-based institutions like yung sa UP NOAA under Dr. Mahar Lagmay na kasama din natin dati. So, ang dami na ngayon. Now, there's no choice for us because we are annexed to the Great Pacific Ocean, and we are, of course, archipelago. All we have to do is just to readjust on two things. Number one is yung ating mga structural mitigation projects. No? We have to create community which are resilient. Yung may mga smart houses tayo na pwedeng umangat pagbaha, and our monitoring systems must be adequate enough to give us prior alarm para kung darating yung mga baha, bagyo, na-abiso yung community. Our evacuation areas must be so ideal that it cannot be a place where we can harbor outbreak or some sort of epidemic. Ang ating educational system must be adaptable to the changes of the weather. No? Mabilis tayo kailangan mag-hybrid kung kailangan para hindi ma-impede yung ating edukasyon ng mga kabataan. So the way to look forward into the future by looking at science, no, is for us to really create a resilient culture. There's no other way, Mix. This is us already in the Philippines, and we don't have any choice at all.
All right. So there you have it. Thank you so much and stay safe on your journey, Dr. Ted Esguerra. Thank you so much, as always, Dr. Ted, for the insights and hope to have you again. Thank you, Dr. Ted.
Mabuhay po at isang wintas naman.
Mabuhay po. Thank you po.